Today I was talking about a analysis of the Navigate registry. The Navigate registry was a multi-center trial that looked at 1,200 patients who had navigational bronchoscopy, and it was really a study based around safety. This was a secondary analysis of the biopsy tools that were used in the study, recognizing that although we talk a lot about the technology being an important part of the procedure, but at the end of the day, it's about obtaining tissue. So when you're doing a diagnostic bronchoscopy, in addition to using navigation systems or whatever to get to the lesion, you actually have to obtain tissue and see if that tissue is valuable in terms of making a clinical diagnosis. And what was interesting about our findings were that all bronchoscopy is local. So although we may use the same technology to get to the lesion, there is a very vast difference of how people actually obtain tissue. In our particular study, we decided to look at three things. One was safety. So anytime you do a biopsy on someone, we're looking at safety. And we broke it down into two groups. So we defined a sort of extended biopsy tool group, which is standard biopsy forceps, cytology brushes, and a wash, with extended strategy, which was peripheral needle biopsy, triple needle brush, needle biopsy, etc., a number of different new tools, and looked at to see if the yields were similar between the two groups and if the complication rates were different for the two groups. And then we also looked at the general utility of rapid on-site cytologic evaluation, which is the procedure where during the procedure we'll obtain specimens and do a rapid stain on the material, and the pathologist would give us a read back immediately about adequacy. So first thing we learned that there were certainly far more diagnostic procedures in individuals who use an extended strategy, so meaning they use needles and forceps and brushes and different biopsy tools during the procedure, compared to individuals who did use a more limited biopsy yield, a biopsy strategy. And then we learned that even though they may use a more extended strategy, they didn't make the procedure significantly longer. So just because you're using a smaller number of instruments didn't necessarily save you a lot of time. So you could do more kinds of biopsies with an extended strategy. We also learned that adding the cytopathology step, so actually taking the slide and sending it to a pathologist to read right there in the room, didn't necessarily add a lot of time to the procedure. And again, that may be local stuff. It may be that they're not waiting for the answers, that they're just continuing to move on. But nevertheless, it didn't add anything to the length of the procedure. And of course, the third part was safety, that even though we used needles and additional complex biopsy techniques, it didn't significantly increase the risk of the procedure in any way. So although the there is wide variation in how people use the tools and which tools they use first, the mere fact that using multiple tools in a procedure is associated with a higher yield with same safety and no impact on time. So that's the general gist of it. There's way more to it than that, really, in that we looked at people whose strategies are very different. Some people have a very strict regimen to how they do the procedures. Other centers have no specific strategy. They seem to adjust to the lesion or the procedures. So there's a lot to be said about the technology, but there's also a lot to be said and learned about the basics of the procedure, where actually getting tissue is very different.